I'm going to let you explore that code we just looked at on your own during the project portion of this lesson. There's just one more thing I want to cover, though, before I set you loose on that, and that is how to think about selecting how many principal components you should look at. So in that last example, they went from 1,850 features on the input to 150 principal components. And the question you might be wondering is, how did they come up with that number? It's a little bit tough to answer that because there's no cut and dry answer for how many principal components you should use. You kind of have to figure it out. Which of these options do you think sounds like a good way to figure out how many principal components you should be using? Here are your options. The first one is just always take the top 10% as a rule of thumb. The second option is that you can train on a different number of principal components and then see how the accuracy responds for each of those possible numbers of principal components. And that once you do this several times, it'll become clear that there's a point of diminishing returns where as you add more principal components, you don't get much more in terms of discrimination, and that you should cut off once you start to plateau. And the third option is that you could perform feature selection on the input features before you put them into PCA, and then you just use as many principal components as you had from input features after you've performed that selection.